Hi guys, Karen and CJ here to talk to you for a few minutes about 4th of July. So there's a few ways that we can make this holiday a little bit more enjoyable for our dog. Because believe it or not, July 5th is actually the number one intake day at shelters around the country because dogs run away out of fear when all those fireworks are going off. So let's help prepare our dogs so hopefully they don't do that. The first thing I want you to do is I want you to make sure that your dog's ID tags and microchip are up to date. Maybe you've moved, maybe your number has changed. We want to make sure that should your dog run away, we are able to get them back to you as fast as humanly possible. Now, the next thing I want you to be aware of is that you should not be taking your dog to fireworks displays. Whether it's in your backyard or you're going somewhere to watch them, please leave your dog at home. You know what's about to happen, you know what's coming, but your dog doesn't. They just know that they are out with their human enjoying this beautiful night. And then the sky explodes, and that's really scary. They can slip their collar, or even if they're panicking enough, they can slip out of their harness. And we don't want to lose our dog. So please leave them at home. They will thank you for that. Now that you've made the decision to leave your dog at home for the 4th of July, which is the right decision, we want to set our dog up for success. And how we do that is we give them a safe space in your home where they can go and they can't hear or see the sounds and sights of the fireworks. That means you're going to want to set them up in a room that's pretty dark and that the curtains are closed, and maybe you even have heavy curtains on the windows to help keep the sounds out. If you don't have heavy curtains, that's okay. You don't have to rush out to buy any. But what you can do is you can set up a fan or a white noise machine or even play some music for your dog. On top of that, in this space, you're going to want to give them something super fantastic to do. Whether it's licky mats or topples or a Kong, whatever your dog finds most enjoyable. This will help keep them distracted and focused on something else other than panicking. So you've set up a safe spot for your dog to go, but maybe they don't want to go in it. Maybe they would rather stay with you and you've decided to stay home with your dog. Fantastic. But how can we make it a little bit more enjoyable for them to hear those sounds and maybe see the flashes? Well, the beautiful thing is that we live in a great time of technology, so you can pull up some videos on YouTube of firework sounds, and you're going to start at the lowest level possible. And as long as your dog is not panting or whining or it's starting to cause them distress at that lowest level, you'll pay them some yummy treats for being calm and hearing that. Then you turn it off and you try it again a little bit later, increasing the volume just a little bit. Pay them some yummy treats for being calm, turn it off, and do another session later, increasing the volume. You're going to be going at your dog's speed here, so don't try to rush to the highest volume as soon as possible. We want our dogs to build up an association of those loud booms equal treats instead of loud booms equal panic. This does take time, and it may not work in time for this year's 4th of July if you're just viewing this now, but it may work for next 4th of July. That's why I really encourage you to create a room for your dog with loads of good things to keep them interested in that instead of trying to run away. And please don't forget to update those tags and microchips if need be. If you are really struggling with a dog that has sound sensitivity issues, whether it's fireworks or thunderstorms or gunshots or the garbage truck, please feel free to reach out and I'd be happy to help further. Otherwise, don't forget to tell your dog I said hi and we'll see you next time.